Okay, a very warm good evening to all the viewers of Ahmedabad Book Club and Karma Foundation. As is correctly said that a good conversation is a cure for the soul. And if we had a good one, then it can really shift the directions forever. A very good evening. I'm Aditi Singh and I'm your host for this session. And I'm very honored to have with us our honor of guest, who is not only a student, but an entrepreneur, an event manager, and the founder of the Russell of Book Club. Besides that, sir, you're also the founder of the Spectrum series, the Evening Talks, Arts and Literature Fest, Author Interaction, and Author Fest. And apart from acing all these professional arenas, you have also been an eminent speaker at Golf Pair 54, and platform of speaking about golf and its future in our country. So, sir, we are very excited to have you. And I really want to know from your side that what are your views on having in this session? So just, so your views, the stage is yours.
If I may intervene over here, Rahul has a sore throat today. So I am his ghost voice, so to say. I will be speaking on his behalf because his throat is really sore. And he did not want to postpone this event. So I'm kind of speaking on his behalf. Rahul is immensely, immensely grateful to the Ahmedabad Club, Book Club, for giving him this opportunity. A young man, his stature, very rarely gets to be on this side of the table. He can well imagine being the interviewer, but not the interviewee. So it's a real honor and a privilege for Rahul to be here and to be acknowledged for those little endeavors that he has started.
Okay. So, sir, like, it's our privilege also to have you on our session. And like, as we all know that you are a multi-talented person, like you have done so many different things. So like, how do you manage this? Like, you have so many various things in your kitty, and at this tender age, how do you manage this? And with this, we'll start with our Q&A session, and I have prepared so many questions for you. So here we go with the first question. As we know that, sir, you are a student also, and like, at this tender age, you have decided that your direction and what your path would be. So, sir, just do tell me that what was the key inspiration or the epiphany moment in your life when it all got decided? So what was that moment and what was the time?
Very ironical, COVID shook the world. It shook the foundations of life and liberty, and people were succumbing to all the grave dangers that COVID posed. But it also brought in a lot of time for students to be sitting at home. And studies is a very mundane chore. So a few people did look for different opportunities, and the online platform, which became a regular feature for their classes, proved to be the hub of his creativity. He realized that he had this particular potential. He's always enjoyed the stage. He's always enjoyed flaunting his creativity. And what better than this particular social platform where he could bring in so many like-minded people. That is the story. So COVID, which brought in destruction, had its own plus points also.
So like, as you told us about this, in this pandemic situation, you were very productive. But let me tell you honestly, sir, like, we, the young generation, we have become very lazy in this COVID time. Because I myself is a student, and this online classes and everything has made us quite lazy. So like, what did happen to you? And like, you were so productive. So where did that come from? Where did that energy come from being so productive in this lockdown? So tell us about that.
It was that sheer boredom, absolute, complete boredom of not being able to do anything, getting scoldings from both parents. All right. That is when he said, well, let me try my hand at something. And then that started off with poetry writing. He said, let's look at poetry writing. He'd been sitting at home, and there is the Story Mirror, which kind of publishes students' books. So he put in a poem over there, realized that Story Mirror was conducting so many online sessions. So he said, why not talk to like-minded people of the Story Mirror and kind of get their ideas and spread those ideas into the world about how to compose poetry. That was how the Spectrum series came into being. The first episode of Spectrum series was very appreciated, and everybody thought it was very productive. And of course, this is a time when everybody is good at languages. We've moved into a generation where everybody wants their story to be told, their story to be heard. And you have a lot of confidence. This is a confident generation. Not the generation that was told to subdue their desires, but a generation which is told to flaunt their desires. So then he realized that he could do more. Again, a student, he was studying computer sciences. So the next Spectrum series spoke about the video making and the PPTs, very simple topics. And he invited all his computer teachers and a couple of other computer teachers, and realized that he could actually become a host at a panel discussion. So that kind of enhanced his confidence. From there, we had just been on a holiday to Rajasthan. Noida-based people find it very easy to go around in the northern areas, Punjab and Rajasthan and Shimla and Himalayas. So Rajasthan was fascinating. He got together the history of Rajasthan, invited a whole lot of social studies teachers. Remember, he's a student. So he got together and he spread this message around on Facebook, on Twitter, on other social media platforms. He'll tell you which are the other ones. And he...
About
18 history teachers and a couple of, no, sorry, it is 80 English history teachers who attended that panel discussion, and they kind of looked at every aspect of Rajasthan, things that you could never imagine, right from the food to the culture to the history, you name it, and how Rajasthan was unraveled. So that was Rajasthan, and that the confidence moved on. Then he started the evening talks because he's also very fond of music. He enjoys playing the guitar, but this is just an amateur thing. So he wanted to bring in people who had started on different aspects. So he called them over one by one, and thus started evening talks. Every week or every 4 days, he invited people from different fields to talk. This was not a conversation. This was just a monologue by people, eminent people from various fields. And this went live on Facebook. And, you know, it was very encouraging for everybody to see it. And people got a good platform to display their talent. This is how it all began. And this gave him a lot of confidence.
So I can really figure out that he never had a writer's block or anything of such sort. He was always productive, and you guys had your dots connected, and at the end of the day, your entire lockdown was very productive. I can figure out from that. And that is really, I can say, in contrast with the young generation right now, because we are tend to be lazy when we don't have things to do, but you have taken the right advantage of boredom, sir. And it is great to listen that you have been to different places and you have explored opportunities and taken advantage of that. So that's a great, great thing. And having said that, let's move towards your second professional arena that you have been acing. That's event management. So event manager, right? A creative, inspiring and thing to do, which need utmost patience. I mean, when you do something, when you manage something, you have a lot of responsibility to handle. So do tell us that what do you think of this, and what kind of event have you managed? Like, what are the events that you have managed? Do tell us about that.
One of the most important events that he managed and what he takes pride in is the Arts and Literature Fest.
Wow.
This came into his mind, and he went around to Facebook, he went to LinkedIn, found a gamut of talent over there, associated with different people, told them that he wanted to start this kind of a thing, and he, I don't know how people fell into it. There was this passion in him, and he enrolled a lot of people, people who are so much older than him. There is this lady, Aparna Kunde, who was a radio jockey. She joined hands with him, and she's got this magical voice. She's a storyteller, a radio jockey. Her husband is, he does the doodle art, very creative couple. So Aparna and Rahul joined hands. Then they befriended another lady called Bhavneet, who branched out later. Bhavneet is as old as Rahul's mother. So between the three of them, they conducted a three-day art and literature fest. 4 days. I'm sorry, it was a...
3 days to get at the studio of our cabin. Everyone's healthy. Labyrinth, all 3 days to get. Interaction and activity, all of that.
Yeah. So I'm sorry I didn't take the name of Sudhir, who was his computer, the tech whiz. He planned the entire thing. The posters were created by him. The entire IT productions was done by a gentleman called Sudhir. So, and Aparna, of course, was the voice. Rahul was the organizing person. Bhavneet and Rahul organized it. Bhavneet came in with her experience. Rahul came in with his passion. And of course, the advantage of having studied in good schools. Because in schools, he had seen a lot of functions happening, a lot of cultural events happening. So he took inspiration from there and he brought it to the level of every child. He'd seen it for the elite in his school, and these competitions were made available to children across the country.
Now, ma'am, like, that was really very inspiring, sir. Like, you have really taken every event in your life and you have really put it into work, into the bigger picture. And it is really an inspiration for all the viewers and for me as a youngster, because if you can do it, then of course we all can. And having said that, and I have another question for you. Like, in any moment during any event, which like you have managed particularly, and at the end it was all okay, and how did it impacted you? I mean, what was the impact when you manage such event, particularly when you do it personally? So what's the impact of that, sir?
To answer this question for Rahul, for him it is a moment of euphoria. You know, the sense of achievement where it's a terrible time when everybody was saying that things will be difficult and academics doesn't interest you, and suddenly you have this moment of euphoria and everybody, your teachers tell you that you've been wonderful. So it was very, very inspiring. He has this amazing school principal, Dr. Shashi Banerjee, principal of Shiv Nadar School, and when it is a go ahead from her, a thumbs up from her, a pat from her, I think that makes his day, and this is something he's going to remember for a lifetime. So his teachers have been very, very motivating. They have believed in him. His sister, who treats him around, you know, whenever anything is successful, so then he gets special treats from her. He's getting a laptop now after this. Wow. So these are the kind of things that keep him going. And of course, the fact that when he got this invite from the Ahmedabad Book Club, believe me, he's told everybody. All his teachers have been told about this.
Wow.
So that's a real high moment. And another thing is that the best students in school always get their commendations. But you do not have to be the best in academics to be good in life. So Rahul's story just proves that.
Such an inspiration, sir. Such an inspirational story. I mean, you even had such amount of good people backing you up. You had a great family to support you, great faculties, and you had your thoughts very clear. I mean, at this tender age, who has his thoughts clear? We are always confused in doing this or doing that. We are like scattered a little bit. But you, on the other hand, sir, your mindset was very clear that I want to be very productive. I want to put into work of all the ideas that I have. So thank you for that answer. And having said that, I also know that you are the founder of the Spectrum series, right, of webinars. So which are the areas in which you have organized webinars? And what is the purpose of organizing it? Like, do tell us that what is the purpose of that very organization system that you are a part of? Yes, sir.
The webinar series that started, the Spectrum series, was basically where he started writing poetry, and other students, his friends, asked him that what is it that you need to write? I mean, how do you plan to go about it, and how to get a poem published? When you write something, you want it to be published also, because everybody looks for a little bit of fame. So the first Spectrum series, which was about poetry writing, spoke about two aspects. The first was the actual composition of the poetry, the content, the technicalities, and the second was how to get it published. So if you get your work published, that kind of takes you to posterity. I guess that was the reason as to, and the achievement, the accomplishment, the aim behind it.
Wow. So like, you had such inspirations to move ahead. I mean, and also, so like, there are so many budding authors out there. Even I write poems as well. So I can totally relate at this level. And even in the comment sections also, people are like whole praising you, because your life story has been an inspiration for all of us. And trust me, when I talked about it, that I'm going to have a session with you, like, most of them, they already knew about you. And they were like, how fortunate you are to interview him. So, like, having said that, so it's really an inspiration. And let's just talk about the evening talk. We are having a conversation. You also are the founder of the evening talks and author interactions, right? You are an eminent part of it. So, so to tell us that, especially, how did this journey start? Like, how did you end it up from being a writer or a poet? From there, you went to this. Like, how did this happen, the transition? So tell us about that, sir.
He had been looking at a lot of people as motivation, as role models, and you know, these people are very easy to admire from a distance, but you want to get closer to them. You want to understand what was it in their journey. Was their path a very rosy path, or were there thorns in their path? Because when you look at the result, you look at the final result, it all seems very, very, there's a lot of glamour attached to it. But the journey, the beginning, is a very difficult one. So to understand those journeys, he actually approached those people and asked them to speak about themselves. That is how evening talks started. And it proved to be quite fruitful, because he, in his evening talks, he not only had authors and poets coming up, but also motivational speakers. And one thing about Rahul is that there's nothing that stops him. He's a very confident boy. He actually went ahead and invited Dr. Kiran Bedi. When she was the governor of Pondicherry, he actually went and invited her. He got a positive response from her office. Of course, her persona was so large that she didn't come down to his level, which did not mean that her office did not respond to it. They were very respectful in their response. The first thing that they did was that they reacted. They reacted to the fact that his invitation had been received and what was it like. So there was this proper conversation going on between her officers on special duty and him. So there was this exchange of mails, phone calls. And then, of course, her busy persona. So she could not make it for it. For his evening talks, but that gave him a lot of confidence. So there was nothing that stopped him. Now, there is this, the chef, the very famous chef, Sanjeev Kapoor. Rahul is aiming to interview him. Wow. Again, Sanjeev Kapoor's persona is almost larger than life. So it might not happen, but that does not mean that he will not try. He'll give it his best shot. So where others kind of don't garner the confidence, they are more pragmatic, they are practical, Rahul allows his dreams to flourish. I mean, let the dream be pipe dreams, but if there are no dreams, what do you work towards? So there are the realities of the authors he actually meets up with, the very eminent people like Sandeep now. Then there is who's that gentleman? Miss Kiran Bedi's son-in-law. Ruzeb. Mr. Ruzeb, a very potent philosophical writer who is interviewed, and he's also interviewed the NSS Delhi chief. So there are all people who agreed to come over, and they are interviewed by him, and so on and so forth. So it's a journey that carries on. So dreams, there is never any end to dreams and aspirations.
Okay, sir.
Mr. KP Singh, who is the NSS chief of New Delhi. He is the NSS commissioner for the entire country.
Yes, sir. Alex, sir, like having or listening to you all your like points, I can figure out that for you, sky is no more the limit. You dream big and you really have the confidence in the world to achieve it. I mean, as ma'am said, that you really approached Kiran Bedi. Like, you didn't even thought for a second that she would have said no, because you really wanted to invite her for your talks. I mean, this is the courage that we all need to have nowadays. First, what happens now, we have skills, we have talent, but we are like, don't have that much of courage. And we are not brave hearts to go beyond our comfort zone and ask out people like who really plays an important role in our lives. But in your case, sir, it's really inspiring because you have the confidence in the whole world to approach people who have such great and eminent personality. Now, it's really inspiring to listen to you, sir. And apart from that, sir, you have also arranged art and literature festival and author fest. So it's online or offline? What is purpose and vision of it, sir?
This was an online thing. The entire thing all started during the pandemic, COVID. And like I told you a little before this, having done the evening talks, I mean, these things go on for quite some time and then certain things taper away. Again, Rahul is the type, you very rightly said, if I may say so, a brave heart. He takes on another course. So the arts and literature fest kind of came into being. He'd seen these kind of fests happening in school, but because of COVID, nothing seemed to be happening in his life. So he organized an online arts and literature fest, which was available for multiple schools across the country. Wherever he could make inroads, he sent invitations and a lot of people responded to it. And of course, he had his team, wherein he brought in people like Sudhir, Aparna, of Neat, and all of them kind of work that magic. The 4-day festival, very demanding, very exhausting, but very exciting. Yes, and Ripunjay also, who's a research scholar from Delhi University. He's doing his PhD in history. And now, of course, there is Sohail Mathur, who's also joined hands with Rahul. Sohail is another literary, he's a literary connoisseur. He knows a lot of authors, he connects with them, and so publishers. He is into the literary world. So he brings in a lot of literary authors, various authors who've written in different genres. And those are the kind of people, the actors, publishers, you name it, they are all there. Sohail has his connects and Rahul has latched on to him. So between the two of them, they are organizing the author fest.
Wow. So like, it's amazing. Like, this is an amalgamation of art and literature and whatnot. I mean, as you correctly said, you name it and sir has done it. And I'm really very amazed and appalled at the same time to listen to all such great achievements, sir. And like, apart from all these professional arenas and academic arenas, I know that you really love to play golf, right? And you like golf as a game. So tell us that what was your experience about golf par 5-4? Because you went there as an eminent speaker. So how was it being invited to such an international like platform, and like, what was it experiencing? How was it, sir? So tell us about that.
This particular platform, Golf Par 54, basically it dealt with people who are passionate about golf, eminent people, actual golfers from across the world sitting over there, and the youngest amongst them. They're all, you know, there was the member of the Rajya Sabha, member of the Lok Sabha, and active golfers from the US,
Australia, England, UK. Probably from overall the world.
Yeah. And one of the people who's associated with this, a lady called Mrs. Anar Mehta, realized that Rahul was also fond of golf and wanted to have a say. Anar Mehta is keenly associated with the Russell of Book Club, and when Rahul expressed his interest, so she pushed him a little forward, and of course, then his own personal initiative took him onto that particular stage, and he managed to interact with the creme de la creme of golf in India. He's been promised a hat with the signature of a gentleman called Mr. Ronald, who is a golf coach and a golf player from the US. England, and he's enjoyed it. So he actually spoke about the fact now golf is a game which does not need a team. You can be an individual player. So people who find it difficult to play in teams cannot be very, very active in team games, can play golf. And it is the thought that golf is only a rich man's game. These are misconceptions. So those are also removed, that golf can be played by women, by children, and by people from all strata of life. You can be trained in your local ground for playing golf.
Wow, ma'am. I mean, like, really, we have this myth that golf is such a posh game. It's like designed for upper class people. I mean, we have seen in pictures, and it's been depicted like that, that people who are like very good in earnings and everything, like they have this great privilege. Privileged people actually can play golf. But you have shattered that myth and broken that stereotype and norm, sir. Kudos to you for doing it. And I've also created a correct mindset among the youngsters and people that if you are interested into something and if you do an effort, you're a tad bit, you can really do things about it. So it was great listening about the whole golf story that ma'am shared with us. And like we all know that you love and admire literature. Above all of your love for literature and expressing thoughts has made you write Sound of Words. If I'm not wrong, tell viewers and all the people listening to us your journey of writing and how this book happened. So do tell us how this happened to you. Like, how do you started writing the book?
Like all young people are coerced into writing poems in class, and those poems when they are read in front of the class, the child feels very proud. So Rahul also got initiated into writing poetry. And in his school, we have this session of
spoken word.
The spoken word, wherein children go and recite their self-composed poetry. So Rahul participated in the spoken word for the last 3 years. This year it didn't happen because of the online thing. So he would go and participate in the spoken word. Yeah. So from 2017, he's been part of the spoken word, and he's enjoyed reciting his self-composed poems, wherein he's got a lot of adulation from his peers, from his teachers. That kind of initiated him into pushing his levels and writing more poetry. And so much so that he kind of wrote an entire anthology of 48 poems. Wow. Again, you know Rahul, you've seen Rahul, 48 poems on him, and he wanted to get them published. So we actually compiled everything, but stopped short of the actual publication. The book is not got published, but it is ready. The day we are able to find a good publisher and the deal is a good one, it'll get published also. So just the sound, the music, the magic, and those words have created the Sound of Words.
And sir, any favorite literature piece that you love? I mean, because everyone who is into literature, they have this fascination of learning international, national, and regional literature, right? So any favorite piece of beautiful literature that you admire the most and that inspires you the most? Do tell us about that.
His favorite piece of reading is a novel, which I think he's read 3 times, To Serve with Love. He's very fond of that particular book. He's watched that movie. And I guess the reason that he's so fond of it is that he can connect with it. It's a typical story of a teacher and students and how there are students who are naughty in class. So any child would be able to identify with all the acts of naughtiness and, you know, going astray in class, playing truant. So I guess that is why he's fond of that particular book. The language is easy and it's a quick flow. He's always enjoyed it.
So it is just great to know your favorite piece of literature. And I'm really like happy to know that when you read something, you relate that to yourself. Now, that's a great thing to do, because nowadays, like, reading has become very frivolous. People just take a book and they just read it. And when you relate to it, it takes you to another level and another notch. So that's great, sir. And like, you have also co-authored Mon Amour anthologies and two of your poetries published. So why co-authoring and with whom you did it? What is the idea behind the book and the theme of your poetry? So tell us about the theme and the idea of the book that you have co-authored. And why did you co-author? Like, why you didn't write it alone?
The fact that Sound of Words could not get published. He's always been fascinated by poems of nature. Our holidays, I guess, have been related to the mountains and of course the sea also. So he's seen a lot of nature and he's been inspired by it. So when it comes to writing poetry, a lot of his poetry is inspired by nature. Sound of Words could not get published for multiple reasons. Maybe it was a lack of pushing from his parental side. We should have been more aggressive about it, but we allowed it. I mean, there's a lifetime ahead of him wherein he can get his work published. But Rahul would not be stopped. If Sound of Words could not get published, he found himself a co-author, Swapnil, who was publishing this book, Mon Amour. Swapnil was the co-author. So he put in his poems with Swapnil and got his work published. So that is the dauntless man who, if one thing doesn't work out, finds a way to complete his mission, his desire, fulfill his ambitions.
Wow. And that's absolutely amazing, because Sir Clear has a mission and he has a vision for it. I mean, you are like, nothing stops you. If you have your eyes set onto something, you figure your way out, not this through other way out, right, sir? And like, you have quite done great for yourself. Like, at this age, you have done great for yourself. So do tell us that, how does it feel to reach here at such young age? Like, you have reached such a great position in your life. So how does it feel? And at this tender age, so many things have happened to you. So many good things indeed has happened to you. And those, you have made it. Like, you have made your pathways to, like, staircase to success. You didn't have it given to you in a plate. You did it on your own. So how do you manage all this, and like, what is your success mantra? Do tell us to all the young viewers, what is your success mantra, sir? I would also love to know it.
Rahul loves the stage. He loves adulation. Some of us aspire for the stage, aspire for adulation, aspire for admiration. And whatever you want, if you pursue it, if not one thing, then if not the moon, the stars are definitely yours. Whatever you want, if you want it desperately and with all your fervor and passion, you're definitely bound to reach somewhere. So Rahul looks for public adoration. He would love to be an actor. He'd love to be on stage. He'd love to be voicing his own opinions, be seen by people. That's a future dream. But right now, whatever he can do, he does it. And if one path doesn't work out, then there's definitely another path. And like people, you go to big publications and you are not able to get your work published. But there are other publications, places like Story Mirror, which publish your work. There are n number of publications, online publications. You just have to work a little harder to find your place, to carve your niche. And it is a lot of personal initiative. I mean, all of you have so much at your fingertips, thanks to the Google, thanks to social media, thanks to the availability. One generation ago, these things were not available. Today, everything is available. It is at your fingertips. You just have to work a little hard towards finding it.
Yeah.
So spend a lot of time on the net. Believe me, every dream will come true. Every search will come true.
Ma'am, like when you say spend a lot of time on internet, like that's very ironical, because when we spend a lot of time, we literally spend our time. We don't do it in a very productive manner. And so, like you have done so many things, but I have a very crucial question. When you do so many things, there comes a very big question in the picture. That's about time and managing time. And since you have managed event, it would not be wrong to ask you that how do you manage time for such a variety of things that you do? I mean, you write, you read, you love to act, you love to do theaters, you love to be on stage and whatnot. Like, how do you do such, how do you manage such thing? Like, what is the time management mantra from your side? Do tell us about your time management skills so that it will help us in managing our time.
He is very clear about the time that he spends on his hobbies. The rest comes out of sheer coercion. For everybody, the mantra of time management is that put in 2 hours of qualitative time for studies. More than 2 hours every day is something that nobody does. Other than that, you're whiling your time away. So whenever you study, study with your heart and mind and soul. And then if you put in 2 hours into qualitative studies, put in 3 hours into finding your dreams and your passion.
Okay, so ma'am, you said that whatever sir does is just like his hobbies. I mean, he is into every like part of the success that he has been. Like he's a, if he does singing, then he loves it. If he plays guitar, then he absolutely loves it. I mean, you believe in living in the moment. You are always present in the moment in whatever you are doing. And that's very rare, because nowadays we have scattered energies. I mean, if we have thousands of plans in our headset, we have time, but we are so scattered that we don't like really focus on one activity at a time. I mean, if I'm doing something, I'll have my mindset on two other things. But you really manage to do it like one time, one goal. I mean, baby steps towards achieving a bigger goal. So that's really great. And as ma'am said about your hobbies, so let me ask you something about your hobbies. Tell us about your hobbies and your life apart from all this. Like, what other stuff you do from having your hobbies as your like career inspiration? Like, what other things? Do tell us about that, sir.
The hobbies are, he loves singing, he loves dancing. He's been trained for Zumba dancing.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, there was gymming prior to the COVID time. Yeah, so he's already done that. Now all of this, apart from that, he also likes cooking. He's very fond of cooking.
Yeah.
And the service industry is something that he would like to find a career in. Because he likes organizing things, he's good at cooking, laying out things. So service industry, you know, getting dressed, talking to a lot of people, he's got interpersonal skills. So I guess that is what the aim is. This is the dream. Let's see whether it sees its fruition or there's some different kind of fruition available.
So basically, sir, you are people's person. I mean, you love stage. Any mantle is a like stage and you are ready to entertain people, right? And like having ma'am said that you love serving, like you love when you are into something which really serves the society or people, and that's a very, very, very novel thought, and that really helps people who are unprivileged to be a part of something that they really deserve, but due to circumstances they are not able to be a part of it. So, sir, like having said that, can you tell us any further projects you are working on? I mean, apart from such a big list of things that you do, I mean, the list is endless and it goes on and on. I mean, I went through it and you name them and you are there, all the activities. So apart from all this huge, I mean, quite a good number of activities you are doing, any other further project you are working on? I mean, some sort of spoiler alert for all the people. I mean, other activities that you're working on. Do tell us about that, sir.
As of now, the Author Fest is his major agenda.
Yeah.
After that, even I don't. Rahul, is there something else? I don't think he's got anything in the pipeline right now. Okay, so there is a Hindi festival in the pipeline. After RBC, there's Youth Parliament and the Hindi festival, which is being planned. And of course, some activities, science activities, which RBC is planning. So the list just goes on, and ideas will keep coming in, and they'll keep flowing out. Okay. The next thing is the on the series is the Baatcheet series that he's starting with. It's already started. The Baatcheet series is conversations with performing artists from various fields from across the country.
So, like, you have quite things in the pipelines. I mean, so many things to do. Like, if we have two more lockdowns, your lockdowns will be completely full. I mean, like, we should not have. I mean, like, you are, like, how do you do that? I mean, like, I am a student, I'm stuck with my exams and then next semester. I don't have such ideas. But you, on the other hand, you have quite a bucket list. I'll say that. Quite a bucket list. And you have so many things and still you have ideas popping into your head now. I mean, that's amazing, sir. And like, as they always say, that anything that starts and that's beautiful, that has to come to an end. And such was this session. I thoroughly enjoyed every moment of it, interacting with you, and especially thank you to ma'am. And towards the end, I have one question that please tell us and do share some wisdom, some thoughts, and enlighten all the young generations and all the viewers that what to do in life that really gives meaning to what are you? It really gives meaning to some identity that you really want to be a part of. Do tell us, because your story is full of grit and guts. You are a gutsy man, I would say, a brave heart and a beautiful, beautiful soul and a very hardworking person with a lot of ideas. And as they say, that creativity is the currency of 21st century and you are hands down very creative. So sir, do tell us something that what we should really and continue in our lives to make it like quite successful. So do tell us about that, sir.
Aditi, thank you for this entire gamut of praise that you've heaped on Rahul. I do not know whether he really deserves it all, but yes.
He deserves it, ma'am, all of it, yeah.
The fact is that whenever you listen to adults all the time, what you realize is that adults ask you only to be practical. And when you listen to your heart tells you to dream. Dream big, fulfill all your aspirations. So life has to be a good balance between the practical. Your parents will always tell you, your teachers will always advise you to be practical, to find a carve a niche for yourself where there is social stability. But if you follow your dream, if you follow your passion, people will definitely fall in line. They will understand that your achievements, so long as you work hard towards achieving your dreams, people will fall in, they will accept you. The fame that you will get, the applause that you will get, will win them over. Like in the case of Rahul, Rahul's parents have been won over. I am his mother sitting over here, his ghost voice, who knows only half of his dreams. I only help him if and when it is required. Otherwise, it is his own dream, it is his own hard work. So if you want something, you've got to work towards it. And all dreams do achieve, do manage to find fulfillment. There's nothing that goes, hard work never goes waste.
Wow, ma'am. So like you really wanted to say that work hard and everything will fall into place for you.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And it was really great to listen to you, sir, and to you, ma'am. It was really, really our honor to have you for the session. And like any few words that what was your experience and how was your experience being a part of this session? So share that with us, sir.
Okay, Rahul is feeling exuberant.
Wow, that's great, ma'am.
The first time for my life.
Wow.
There is a lot of gratification that a young boy like Rahul can be invited on a show to give, to be interviewed. It's a very gratifying feeling for Rahul. Very, very proud moment. We are immensely thankful to the Ahmedabad Book Club for giving him this opportunity and for giving him a lovely voice like Aditi Singh. So charming, so witty, so full of words and so very positive in attitude. So it's a huge thank you to Aditi for being so warm, welcoming and so full of praise for Rahul. Thank you for acknowledging the work that he's put in, and Ahmedabad Book Club, kudos to them for inspiring these people to move on, both you and Rahul.
Thank you so much, ma'am, and I'm really glad that I have got this opportunity to interview him, because the moment I came to know, I didn't even thought for a second, I just said yes, that I would and I will only interview him. And when I shared it with my friends and family, they were so proud that you have got this opportunity to be sitting in front of him, who has done so much of hard work and created a niche for himself. So ma'am, I'm really, really very honored and also proud at the same time that I have got this, I have bagged this opportunity indeed. So thank you so much, sir, for your valuable time.
One last message that Rahul has just put in for you. Yes. Thanks for culling his name out from LinkedIn and Facebook, because he's the one who goes head hunting. For the first time, he's been head hunted. So yeah, thank you so very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for being such a great spot. And thank you so much, sir, for like taking out time from your busy schedule and also giving us some of the hints of your bucket list that we really liked a lot. And so I'm really looking forward for another session also with you. So I'm really very happy and grateful. Thank you so much, ma'am, and thank you, sir. And it was really a great, great, great session. And comment section is like full of praises for you. I mean, like your story was such an inspirational story, such an ironic story and whatnot. And really it was, sir. And it was my immense pleasure to interview you. Thank you so much, sir. And that was all from my side. And like we are done with the session. And thank you for being a part of it. And thank you so much, ma'am, for being such a great conversationalist and ask and answering all my questions with utmost grace and patience. Thank you so much, ma'am, and thank you, sir.
Thank you, Aditi. It was an absolute pleasure engaging with you. God bless you. May you do very well. May you achieve all your dreams, do very well in your MSc and achieve all your dreams and passions.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, sir.